Ooh.
Think anyone will mind if I just borrow some of these for my system? Hey everyone, Trisha Hershberger here, and you are watching DIY in 5. In today's episode, we're going to talk about what parts you really need for your video editing PC. If you find it useful, be sure to subscribe to see all of our upcoming tips and tricks. You're ready to edit your own videos and share them with the world. But is your rig? When it comes to your processor, get a processor that's multi-core. The more, the better. It's as simple as that. Previously, Intel was your only real choice, but now with AMD Ryzen, you can get much higher performance on a smaller budget. If you're looking at all the CPU options and you're trying to decide between one that overclocks and one that doesn't, just get the one that doesn't. There are some benefits to the extra power overclocking provides, but more often than not, you'll never use the actual benefits an unlocked CPU gives you. Looking pretty. Oh, goddamn. Okay, maybe too much power. For your motherboard, just make sure it's matched to your CPU, has enough ports for expandability, and check user reviews to make sure there are not any common issues among other users. Now for memory. If editing video is more passion than profession, you can start with 16 gigs of RAM. If you're doing more professional work, like editing 4K footage, you should go with 32 gigabytes or more to make sure you have the horsepower to edit those larger files. And if you're thinking about future-proofing, go with the DDR4 system. DDR4 is going to be around longer than DDR3, and in a few years, DDR3 is likely going to be more expensive to upgrade. When it comes to video cards, you're going to want one, plain and simple. Good news is you can still get something that works well on a budget. As little as $200 if you're looking for the ultimate bang for your buck card. There's no need to get a professional workstation video card when most of the standard gaming graphic cards will do. If you have a few extra bucks in the budget and you're trying to decide between a CPU with more cores or slightly better graphics card, go for the CPU. The extra cores will help you out in the long run. Let's move on to storage. You may think that just getting a bigger hard drive is your only choice when it comes to a video editing rig. It's not. We've said it before and we'll say it again. SSDs will save you so much time when you're doing anything with a PC. Your best bet is to use an SSD as a boot drive to run Windows and all your applications. Beyond that, you'll want a larger second hard drive to store all your work files. Where are all my DIYers? If you're building a system, there are a couple of other things to remember. First up is your power supply. Now that you're getting into editing video, you will use more power, plain and simple. For a basic editing PC, 450 watts is where you want to start. It's best to get a power supply that's at least gold rated to make sure you're not just wasting electricity. Cases, on the other hand, are very much a personal preference. The only thing you need to do is make sure the case can fit your motherboard and all your components. You can get ones with glass panels, sound dampening, cable management, and all sorts of other cool features, but none of it is really necessary to make you the next YouTube star. Unless you want to be a tech YouTuber, in which case make sure it's RGB everything. So what's in your editing rig? Any parts you're thinking about updating? Let us know in the comments. Or if you want to know how much RAM you need for your non-video editing rigs, check out this video here. Thanks so much for watching DIY in 5, and I'll see you next time.